You're watching Talk with Audrey. Welcome back. More than 280,000 people are expected to be diagnosed with breast cancer this year, and many of them will survive and thrive. But those with metastatic triple-negative breast cancer, TNBC, have a far less optimistic outlook. Joining me to talk about metastatic triple-negative breast cancer and the outlook for women living with this disease, Ricki Fairley, the CEO and co-founder of Touch, the Black Breast Cancer Alliance and a stage 3A TNBC survivor, and Dr. Monique Gary of the Grandview Health Penn Cancer Network Cancer Program. She treats people with metastatic triple-negative breast cancer. Welcome to both of you.
Thank you. Great to be here, Audrey.
Thanks for having us.
Dr. Gary, what are the signs and symptoms of TNBC?
Triple-negative breast cancer, or TNBC as we call it, is different from the other subtypes of breast cancer in that it is more aggressive. It is named for and characterized by the absence of something called hormone receptors or stations on the cancer cell when we look under the microscope. So the difference really is under the microscope, and it has a difference in how it responds to certain therapies. When we don't have those receptors, we're not able to offer women drugs to prevent recurrence in the same way as some of the other types of breast cancer. And so that means that we see women with more aggressive disease. We find TNBC in women who are younger, under the age of 40, under the age of 35 even, women who have mutations, like BRCA mutations, and also when it becomes metastatic, it becomes more deadly. There are less treatment options. Signs and symptoms of TNBC are the same signs and symptoms of the other subtypes of breast cancer, and the number one sign is no sign at all. It's diagnosed on screening mammography, and this is why it is so important for every woman to get their annual screening mammogram. When there are symptoms, we know that both men and women can feel palpable masses in the breast. We can find skin changes like thickening, like an orange peel. We can see nipple retraction and sometimes find nipple discharge as well. And so if a person sees this, they should visit their doctor immediately.
Which is why it's also really important to know your own body as well. Ricki, tell us about your experience with TNBC.
Yeah, you know, my doctor found my lump on an annual checkup, so it is really important to get those checkups. And I was diagnosed with stage 3A, triple negative. I had a double mastectomy by choice. I did a lot of chemo, a lot of radiation, and a year to the day, my cancer came back, as triple negative often does. My doctor said, okay, you're now metastatic, you have 2 years to live, get your affairs in order. I said, well, I really can't do that right now. I have a daughter who's a sophomore at Dartmouth, and I've got to get her through school. So me, you, and God need to work this out. What have you got for me? I found a TNBC specialist, and she put me on some experimental drugs. And 2 weeks ago, I celebrated 10 years of survivorship. So I'm a miracle.
Wow. Indeed. There you go. And you started Touch, the Black Breast Cancer Alliance. Would you tell us about the organization and the work that you're doing?
Yeah, so Audrey, you know, black breast cancer is a different disease. Black women are getting triple negative at 3 times the rate, and we don't really know why. Our mortality rate is 42% higher than white women, and black women survivors like me have a 71% higher risk of death. We have a 39% recurrence rate, like mine came back, and black women under 35 are getting breast cancer at twice the rate, dying at 3 times the rate. We're getting triple negative at younger ages and later stages. And so when I started, I've been doing advocacy since I was sick, but when I looked around and started thinking about these numbers, I said, well, what's different about black breast cancer? Why are black women dying? It's crazy. We have to bring more science to this conversation. And what we found was that only 3% participation of black women in clinical trial research. So we really don't know. We really don't understand. I mean, I'm here because God left me here to do this work. And I don't know, you know, it's not the same for other women. So I wanted to bring all the parties together that are working in this space to talk about and bring science to the conversation, to bring research to the conversation, to get more black women comfortable with participating in clinical trials and kind of dispel all those myths about clinical trials and get rid of the mistrust and get the research done so that we can find drugs that will work better for our bodies. And that's what we're focused on. We're also focused on educating young women. We have an HBCU internship program to get that conversation about breast health to the kitchen table. You know, Black people, we don't talk about health at the kitchen table. So we have to depend on our young women to not only talk about it with their peers, but also with their families. Know your her story. Talk to your mom. Talk to your grandma. Talk about your family history and talk about what you're up against so that we can make those conversations happen and get more Black women involved in the science.
Dr. Gary, Ricki mentioned health disparities. How does that translate for you in practice, and what are some of the challenges that you're up against as a doctor?
You know, Audrey, so many of the social determinants of health and the socioeconomic barriers confound the research that we'd like to do surrounding this disease. And what we know are that women who live in rural communities, women who have lower socioeconomic status, are less likely to even receive proper screening, especially as a result of COVID-19. We know that they are less likely to be offered three-dimensional mammography. They are less likely to be offered some of the more aggressive therapies, including things like clinical trials. And so there are barriers, not just in access to care, but even within the healthcare system itself. And a prime example of that is when young women present to their doctors with a mass, many times they are turned away. And we need to do a better job of educating both our physicians and healthcare providers, as well as our community, on the signs and symptoms, and that young women can present with breast cancer, and we need to take every single one seriously, and we need to do more to promote health equity.
Yes.
And that's really what we're here today to do, because health equity is only part of the equation and research is the other.
That's such a scary proposition. How is metastatic TNBC treated?
So metastatic TNBC is treated primarily with chemotherapy, which targets the entire body and the fastest growing cells in the body. But there are other therapies, including things like targeted therapies, immunotherapy, that are giving women a better chance at a longer life with metastatic breast cancer, metastatic triple negative breast cancer especially.
Ricki, what would you say to Black women who are watching or listening right now?
Get screened. Know your body. Know your breasts. Do your mammograms, you know, take care of yourself. And you know, Audrey, 77% of Black moms are single moms. So their focus is on their kids, right? We don't always put the mask on ourselves first and focus on ourselves first. You gotta focus on yourself, give yourself a minute, stand in front of the mirror, check your breasts, know your breasts, feel them, and think about your breasts, think about your health. And then know her story, talk to your moms, talk to your grandmas, talk to your aunties, talk to your daughters. Really talk about breast health. Make it a kitchen table conversation so that we talk about it, we know what we're up against, and we take care of ourselves.
All very important things to remember. And of course, we want people to seek out information. I always say informs empowered. Dr. Gary, where can we go for more information?
For more information, everyone can visit our website, touchbbca.org. touchbbca.org, and there you'll find articles, information on clinical trials and research. You'll find a support network of breast cancer survivors and advocates, and you'll find ways to turn this month of breast cancer awareness into breast cancer action, not
yes.
just in October. Every month, every day, our breast health is important, and
yes.
we need to take charge of our health. So go to touchbbca.org.
I want to thank you both for joining me, and Ricki for sharing your story, and Dr. Gary for the work that you're doing to bring awareness to this and to help women advocate for themselves.
Thank you, Audrey.
Thanks so much.